Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, welcome. My name is Victoria and I film from Lagos, Nigeria. And to my returning subscribers, thank you for always coming back to watch my video. So in today's video, I'll be teaching you guys how to add an alias to your account. What is an alias? An alias is an additional email address you add to your existing email address. Did you get it? So your existing email address I'm talking about is your Microsoft account email address. So if you have a product, if you have any of the Microsoft product or subscription, then you definitely have a Microsoft account email address. So that email address you used to sign in, on your Microsoft Word or Excel or PowerPoint or Outlook, whichever one, that is your Microsoft account email address. Okay, so this email address, you can add an additional email address to make them carry your subscription, because normally subscriptions cannot be transferred from one account to another. So if you feel like you want another email to have your subscription, then adding an additional email address to your existing email address is the solution to this, because you can't transfer subscription. The only people that can share subscriptions are people that are using the Office 365 family subscription. These people can share their subscription to 5 people. So if that is something you would like me to show you, I would make a video about that, teaching you how to share your Office 365 family subscription. Okay, so today you are talking about adding alias. Okay, so if this is what you like to know about, please do well to continue watching. Okay, also you can add an alias account if you received an email from your service provider, that's your email service provider, saying that they are closing down the domain or something like that, and you have subscriptions in your account you need to get access to, then you need to add an alias email to your account. Okay, without too much talking, let's get right into showing you guys how to do this. So in my previous video, I showed you guys how to sign into your Microsoft account. So you can check that video on how to sign into your Microsoft account. Okay, I'll link it in the description box below. All right, so we are signing to our Microsoft account. So the next thing to do is to click on your info. So I have your info already. Then you scroll down to sign in preferences. So it brings you to this page. It might ask you to verify your account before it takes you to this page, whichever one. Okay, so we are on the page we want to add the account alias now. So you can decide to add a phone number or an email address. So we want to add an email address. So I click on add email. Okay, so when you're adding an alias account, you cannot add an existing email, an existing Microsoft account email address. You can't add that. But if you want to add an existing email address, make sure that it is not a Microsoft account email already. So if you want to use an outlook.com account, hotmail.com, live.com, msn.com, all those type of email, if you already created that email, you won't be able to add it as an email, as an alias account, because automatically, once you create that email, it's already an Microsoft account email address. So you can't add it here. But an existing email address, maybe like a yahoo.com, gmail.com, btinternet, att.net, that is not an email, that is not a Microsoft account email address, then you can add it here, this box below. So if you want to add an Outlook account, you don't have to go create it first. You can just, you just need to come here and type the email you want. So you come here and type the email you want. You don't go and create an email. That's if you want to use outlook.com domain as your alias account. You don't create the account. You come here to type the account you want. But you can add an existing email address that is not a Microsoft account. So you click on add alias. It says that email is taken. Once you type your email, you click on add. So now you see I have the email address added. So let's try to add an existing email address.
And if you want to read my mind, just go ahead. There's nothing to hide. I'm so depressed. I'm not gonna lie, but your problem.
So you can see that this email address, I already have it as a Microsoft account email, so it doesn't take it. I don't think I have an email that is not a Microsoft account, so I can add it. Okay, so let's go back. So now we've been able to add an email account, that's an alias account, to your existing email address. So now if you want to make it a primary alias, because this is my office email address, it is it can only be changed by my IT, so I can't change it myself. But if you're doing this on your own, you would see make a primary alias at this point. You will see in front of the remove, you see make this a primary alias. So you can click that email to make the new email you added as the primary alias, or you can just add it and just leave it like that way. So this is how to add an alias to your Microsoft account. So one thing you should not do after you've added an alias to your Microsoft account is to remove it. Unless you don't need the account anymore, then you can remove it. But once you know that you are still going to use that account, please don't click remove, because immediately you click on remove, that account will no longer exist. You can't use the account anymore. You can't recreate that account. That means you've totally deleted that account and you cannot use that account anymore. So that is one thing you should not do. All right? Okay, guys, we've come to end of this video. I hope you guys enjoyed and learned few things in this video. Okay, like I said, do not delete any email you add as an alias or your existing email address in your Microsoft account, because it's rendered it invalid. You will not be able to access the account again. So don't delete, like, don't do it. It's a no. Okay, all right, guys, thank you guys so much for watching. Please do well to like, share with your friends. Let me know what you think about this video in the comment section. And if you have any question of what you don't understand, you can tell me in the comment section. Write it in the comment section and I'll make sure to give you an answer. Okay, thank you so much, guys. I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.